Good morning, everyone, and happy Friday. It is Julie here with your TipRanks pre-market morning update, where we're bringing you everything you need to know before the market opens. We'll be covering exciting stock market news, notable earnings reports, as well as the morning's biggest gainers and losers. Now, just before we get into all of that, I do have one quick favor to ask of you guys. If you love TipRanks, make sure you head over to the Google Android Store or the Apple App Store, wherever you use the TipRanks app, and leave us a review letting us know what you love about TipRanks. Next week, I'll read out some of my favorite reviews right here on the show. All right, now let's get right into this morning's exciting stock market news. U.S. stock futures are mixed but leaning a bit more to the red this morning. We have the Dow futures down 0.3%, S&P 500 futures down 0.2%, and NASDAQ futures up 0.07%. The European Union has added the U.S. to its whitelist, meaning that Americans can travel to Europe without facing travel restrictions upon arrival. European leaders are hoping that President Biden extends the same courtesy, allowing European travelers to start coming to the U.S. Walmart is investing in drone service provider DroneUp as it looks to get customers the items they need in the shortest amount of time. The investment builds on a strategic partnership that began last year, resulting in the two companies carrying out drone delivery trials. The investment follows more than 100 drone delivery trials from Walmart stores. The trials have successfully demonstrated that the retailer could offer customers delivery within minutes rather than hours with their current systems. DroneUp is a government-certified service provider and currently operates in 11 states across the U.S. The retailer intends to kickstart its drone delivery service at a store in Arkansas. Analysts rate the Walmart stock a strong buy with an average upside of just over 21%. Electric vehicle company Fisker and Magna International have inked a long-term manufacturing deal for the manufacturing of the Fisker's Ocean SUV. They are scheduled to start the production of the SUV in November of 2022 at Magna's carbon-neutral facility in Austria. Both entities had entered into a cooperative agreement back in October of 2020 related to electric vehicle platform sharing and advanced driver assistance system packages. Magna is a mobility tech company which supplies to the automotive industry, and they host a world-class manufacturing facility in Austria where they've produced more than 3.7 million vehicles. Analysts rate the Fisker stock a moderate buy with an average upside potential of 32%. And the Magna stock also comes in as a strong buy with an upside of 22%, with some recent ratings going as high as 40%. Ford has announced that their earnings before interest and taxes for this next quarter should be higher than expected. And it'll also be considerably higher compared to the year-ago period. Their Q2 results are scheduled for July 28th. Despite industry-wide semiconductor shortages, Ford is witnessing an improvement in its motor business, propelled by lower-than-estimated costs and favorable market conditions. However, the company did state that the net income for their second quarter will be lower when a $3.5 billion gain on Ford's investment in Argo AI is included. Their stock currently comes in as a moderate buy with an average upside of just 2.44%, but again, looking at the most recent ratings, they range between 15 to 21%. Banking giant JP Morgan will be buying Nutmeg. No, I don't mean the spice, but a UK-based digital wealth manager. JP Morgan plans to launch a digital retail bank in the UK under the Chase brand later in the year, which it says Nutmeg will complement. Nutmeg launched in 2012 and now serves more than 140,000 clients and manages more than £3.5 billion in assets. Its offering includes several types of ISAs, general investment accounts, and pensions. The JP Morgan stock comes in as a moderate buy with an average upside of 12%. In the last couple of weeks, we have a hold rating with a downside of 8% and a buy rating of 31%, so analysts are a bit split. Shares of CAI International have soared in the pre-market after it was announced that they will be acquired by Mitsubishi HC Capital. The transportation finance provider has agreed to be acquired at $56 per share and an enterprise value of $2.9 billion. The purchase price represents a premium of over 46% over their closing price on June 17th. Their CEO said that the combination of CAI and Mitsubishi HC Capital, or MHC, will allow MHC to leverage CAI's global marketing and operational expertise, and along with MHC's existing container investments, will provide enhanced value to MHC's container leasing customers, suppliers, employees, and other stakeholders. The transaction is expected to close late Q3 or early Q4 of 2021. The CAI stock only has one analyst rating from 9 days ago that comes in as a buy with an upside of 57%. Hydrofarm will be acquiring Aurora Innovations for $161 million. Hydrofarm manufactures and distributes hydroponics equipment and supplies for controlled environmental agriculture, while Oregon-based Aurora manufactures and supplies organic hydroponic products. Hydrofarm will be adding Aurora's brands such as Roots Organics, Soul Soil, and Procision to its portfolio of branded products. Additionally, the company will benefit from new domestic production and distribution capabilities on the East and West Coasts, along with a peat moss harvesting facility in Canada. The transaction is expected to close in July. The Hydrofarm stock has just two current ratings and comes in as a moderate buy with an average upside of nearly 37%. And finally, we have Danaher Corporation, who's agreed to acquire privately held company Aldevron for $9.6 billion. Danaher is a global science and tech company that designs, manufactures, and markets professional, medical, industrial, and commercial products and services. Aldevron is a manufacturer of high-quality plasmid DNA, mRNA, and proteins, and serves biotechnology and pharmaceutical customers across research, clinical, and commercial applications. The addition of Aldevron to Danaher's life sciences segment will help generate best-in-class products and services and further enable the company to expand in the areas of genomic medicine. The Danaher stock does come in as a strong buy with an average upside of 13.5%. Moving over to notable earnings reports. Yesterday, we heard from Adobe, who reported better than expected Q2 results. The company reported adjusted earnings of $3.03 per share, higher than the $2.81 estimated by analysts, but down slightly from the prior year quarter of $3.14. Their revenues came in at $3.84 billion, surpassing the street's estimates of $3.73 billion and jumping 23% from the year-ago period. Their stock comes in as a strong buy, with multiple analysts reiterating price targets in this last day. The average upside comes in at about 8%. The rest of the day is pretty quiet when it comes to earnings reports, so let's move over to which stocks are this morning's biggest gainers and losers. Starting with our biggest gainer this morning, which we actually already touched on earlier, and that is CAI International. Their stock is up 45% after that news of being acquired by Mitsubishi HC Capital. We also have UTime under UTME. They're currently up 20%. This is following a loss of 72% yesterday. And then Geron Corporation under GERN, who's up over 21% after the publication of some positive phase 2 data. Our biggest losers this morning are led by Orphazyme. Trading under the ticker ORPH, they're currently down 51% after failing to get FDA approval for one of their drugs. Followed by Athira Pharma under ATHA, who's currently down nearly 34% after the decision to place their CEO on a temporary leave. And Capstone Green Energy under CGRN, currently down 26% on the news of a $10 million capital raise. So that is everything for Friday's pre-market morning update, bringing you what you need to know before that opening bell. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and say good morning in the comments down below. I always love hearing from you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a fantastic weekend. Get out there and enjoy the summer, and we will see you back here on Monday.